All right, so we'll be covering Google AdWords today. We'll try to cover a basic premise in the first half, and then we'll start our practical running of how to launch a campaign and how to put an ad in Google AdWords. That we'll start doing after theoretically discussing few points, which will set a base for you guys to understand once we do any practical run. So Google AdWords is like this. What you do is you go as a user or as your customer goes to Google and search out for a product. We're gonna take one case product today so that you understand everything around it, and we have best example with us of an e-commerce site, so let us just pick that. Or to start with the search idea, we can pick any product. So just name me one product which you want to search. Let's say if you want to buy it, what is that you want to buy it, and for that you are into the buying stage. Then you're inquiring about it in a Google. So what do you type over here? Any one of you can prompt me that. iPhone. All right. So it depends. Why do you type iPhone? Today I'll go a little ahead and try to explain the keyword combinations and keywords, because that will become a major part today. I'm gonna write only iPhone. I could have been only trying to understand the features of iPhone in nowhere close to my domain I'm looking to buy it. Yeah, and the websites, the different websites have different purpose. If I have a blogging site related to phones, only iPhone will be more than enough for me to have as a keyword. But if I'm looking to sell it out, like I'm a Flipkart or Amazon or I'm a Snapdeal, a domain like buy iPhone is, or a keyword like buy iPhone 6, these are the particular keywords which are of more interest to me. Yeah, if I am the originator, the manufacturer, the Apple, as in the base, then any keyword which is related to iPhone is more savvy to me. But let's say I type iPhone only, and this is the result I got. Now you must have been knowing I always try to describe it. Here what you see over this side right now, these are the organic listings. So suppose I want to, because it will come out on the top as well, I'm writing it down, buy iPhone 6. Yeah, and you could see over here that this one, the shopping window, and the keyword search ad results coming onto the right hand side, and this one is a paid ad, right? And this one over here, which we have covered in the SEO, these are the organic listings. Now if I want ads to be over here and I'm ready to pay for it, pay as in I want to ready to pay for media, if somebody clicks on that, it's okay, but at least I'll come onto the top, or I'll come on to the site top at least, or I'll come on to the shopping window, and it increases my chances of a click through going on, and increases my chances of having a web traffic, and at the end of the day conversion, whatever the conversion goal. That conversion goal can be an ultimate, if you're an e-commerce site, an ultimate sale happening, or if you are, let's say, a blogging site, then a newsletter sign up can be a conversion. Whatever prime objective of that campaign is, and you're ready to pay for it, you have budgets for it, so you use the help of paid route, and for that the back end which you use, the tool which you're going to use, is Google AdWords, right? To have this clear till here, any problem in SERP, search engine result page? How to understand search engine result page? No problem still here. Ravi, Shubham, Ashalata, it is very easy. I mean, till here you may not have any problem, right? All right, so how to go about Google AdWords? You just go to Google AdWords, and with your Gmail account, you can create an account and you can open an account. So it's up to you which account you want to use. All you have to have a Gmail ID, and then you can go ahead with that. And you can just click and sign in over here. Once you sign in, you'll get to this. This is how the dashboard, the panel looks like. Over here, you can ignore this. Your account is inactive. That's because the payment from Indian credit card is not going through. There is some issue, so we have to contact some reseller for it. And anyways, I'm using this account only for the trial basis. So, never mind. So this is the dashboard, how it looks, top quality keywords which are working on, how the keywords have been performing and all that and all that. But we'll go one by one, right? Don't get confused out of it. There may be a lot of data available in this, in the panel, but don't get confused. So have a symmetry, we'll go very slowly in this and try to understand through this. First of all, you need to understand that Google AdWords or anyways, digital marketing, any prime product is a continual change. So today, if there will be features keep on adding, like for example, I give you an example. This feature of shopping window has come up only recently, 1 or 2 years back. It wasn't there before. E-commerce was not, you know, so substantial that it had come over here. So this is a new product which was added in, or one of the latest products which was added. Then conversions, click-through conversions, we'll go to that, which is also called click per acquisition. That is a new addition which happened. So the base product was ready many years back, but it just, you know, with the changing in the industrial aspect, with the changing in the market, the new products keeps on adding, sub-products keeps on adding in Google AdWords. So the more you practice, the more you'll get to know it. This is what I ultimately want to say. And one thing which you have to understand is that it gives you a power as compared to any other traditional way of advertisement. Can be a TV basis also gives us some measurement, but not a precise measurement, what I could say. Outdoor advertisements, any other pamphlet distribution and all that, these doesn't give you a power what digital marketing gives you in terms of the act. You know, you can precise your target based on the action that they take, the devices which they do, their searches which they do, you know, the locations where they are located. Like for example, if I'm a local store, I do not want to advertise outside my local radius of 5 kilometers, right? Why should I want to do that? But I want to use the digital power within that sphere or within that city, for example, if geographical area, city for that matter. So I can choose according to that. If somehow a language also plays an important role in defining a very regional oriented kind of product, then I can also precise my target based on that, and anything outside that domain, I won't be interested in displaying that. So this gives me that power. Google AdWords will ultimately result you in giving that kind of power. So you can filter your target audience based on that. Three main points which as a Google AdWords user or basically as a digital marketer, you have to keep in mind is that you can it is targeted. So you can target very precisely what you want to do. There will be a very lesser number of pay stage. For example, if I want to advertise for let's say a tea product which Achalata has, right? I have an e-commerce site and I have a new tea which I've launched, an in-house private label tea which I've launched. I want to advertise it, and my area is let's say Delhi NCR, and I put in hooding near Select City Walk near Saket, South Delhi. Yes, it is targeted. I know that I'll have an audience from there, but I cannot measure it precisely. I'll just have a rough figure that there are, you know, 20,000, 30,000 cars flowing up and down on that road. But how many of them actually has seen that is not measurable, right? But it is measurable in case of digital marketing. We know that who exactly has clicked that. We'll, using the keyword and intelligence and little combination, we'll also try and understand what kind of behavior they have, how many chances they have to convert, right? And nowadays we also have a conversion fundamental with us. Like, they have clicked that, they have reached to our website, and had they made any conversion or not, even we can track that. Yeah, so, and it's active all the time. So these are the three advantages which it can give. Whatever we are reading right now, we'll cover that in the practical run when we do. But just to have a little base, we are covering it theoretically right now. One of the questions which always comes up, and people also try to call the behavior of the ad with these names. I mean, they won't say Google AdWord, let's advertise a keyword search ad on Google AdWord. They will say pay-per-click kar de yaar. Pay-per-click wala campaign kar lete hain. So yes, you can use that lingo that jargon industry is using, but I would suggest not to use that. These are the sub ways of doing it. These are only ways, these are only execution tools which you can use it, a choice. But ultimately you're doing a keyword search based ad. This is what you're doing. So as a digital marketer, try to use the specific or the correct lingos and words what you do. So what do we mean by cost per click or pay per click wala kar lo, when we say, or when we say cost per impression, is basically when a ad is coming and I've taken a domain for or the area for pay-per-click, then if I'm clicking on this ad, the advertiser has to pay for it, right? So this is pay-per-click. Pay-per-impression, if in case you are a new brand, the prime objective is to spread the awareness. Even if somebody doesn't click that, doesn't matter, at least it comes onto the top and you want to have a clear visibility. If that is your objective, then you can go ahead with, you know, cost per impressions and pay per impression kind of fundamental. Cost per acquisition is basically what, that you ultimately, if you click on that and you make a conversion, that conversion can be anything. If it's an e-commerce site, can be a sales. And even if it's an e-commerce site, but for you the objective is, because you know that people are not gonna buy in the starting directly once they come up. For me, the conversion is more or less if they reach this page. This is for me is the ultimate conversion which I can count. So you can put a matrix, a barometer over there. And how to put it, we'll just come to the practical running and we'll see that. And this is how you can do that. So you can devise your campaign on three domains, three areas, three ways of running a campaign, and it is linked with the directly cost what you're going to associate with that. Got it? Any issues till here? Any question or what can be cost per click? Basically you got the idea, but Ravi said yes. So you have any issue, you have any Ravi, do you have any query to ask? Okay, all right. Now if you look onto this ad over here, no, this is not the ad, this is the ad. Now if you look onto the ad over here, we could see that this blue color line is the headline. Once we go onto the, Ando is asking what is cost per acquisition. I tell you what is cost per acquisition. For example, let's assume that I type on Google, we are assuming that Ashalata is running a campaign for her ad, right? And I want to have priority, right? And I find it on the top. And this is an organic result, but let's assume that it's a paid result, which is coming on the top. And I clicked on that. Once I clicked on that, I reaches to the website for which Paathshala is running a campaign, right? And she had three choices. Okay, she has this on the window itself. But let's say she had three choices to run a campaign. That could be, once it's been searched over here, and let's assume that it's an ad, and it's an ad has come, and the user, the customer, the prospect has clicked on that, then only she'll pay to Google AdWords or Google, right? And there will be a bid amount for it. There will be an amount which she had signed up that will pay, let's say, for example, ₹5 per click. So instead of that, what she has done, that she'll only pay, so that it has three choices. An impression one, since Google has shown the result and it's an ad, so Google will charge that whatever that amount. That amount could be, let's say, for example, ₹1 per impression. So that ₹1 will be billed to Paathshala. Immaterial if I clicked or haven't clicked on this ad. And suppose she haven't opted for an impression, but have opted for click. So only and only if I click, she will be charged for that amount. And if I click over here, then she'll be charged. Let's say, for example, for that, the charges which were fixed is ₹5. How to fix that charge will come on to once we'll do the practical run. So if I clicked on that, now the billing has happened to Paathshala and she has to pay ₹5. Now that was second option. The third option is, I've searched for it. There is an ad with this over here, and she has opted with Google, through Google AdWords, she has opted for cost per acquisition. Yeah, acquisition or conversion. So what happens is, if I click on that, she won't be charged up till here. But that conversion is being fixed on, let's say, if I sign this newsletter, for example, it could be this, it could be going to T and going to this black or whatever. I'm sorry, the system is a little slow. Going to any product, keeping it in a cart, right? In a shopping cart. And it has come into the shopping cart. Once I click on to add to cart, okay, this could not be, but once I proceed to checkout, let's say this. So what she has done is, she can fix that one step. Could be a page, could be an action. So she have said that if somebody clicks over here, which ultimately has to do it, then for me it's a conversion, it's an acquisition. So I'm ready to pay you, Google. Mr. Google, I'm ready to pay you. This is what she has signed a deal. Or let's say she reaches, or it could be reaches to the payment page and ultimately doing it. So there could be any one page, any one action which can be precise and been said that if this action happens, means a conversion and acquisition for it. And in that case, you have to pay. And let's say for that, she has kept ₹10 as a bidding amount for that. So she has to pay ₹10. Got it? Anto and everybody else. Sangeeta, Ravi, NK. What is cost per acquisition?
Shubhang. Anto, did you got it? Good. Alright, so we are coming to the ads. Okay, now this is the ad which you can see, right? And here, if you see that blue line, this is called the headline, right? Any answer on how many letters are allowed over here? Characters? Changita, 12 to 15. 35. Okay, it is between 25 and 35. Ravi is right, it is 35. So over here it is 35. Right? This is description one line, up to 50% off on selected mobiles. This is description one. Free shipping on orders two is description two. So there are two description lines which are allowed. Each description line allowed for how many characters? Any guesses? These two description line, which is up to 50% off, headline up to 25, description up to 35. You are right, Sandeep. So each description line is 35, not the combination of two. So up to 50% off on selected mobiles. If this is the one description line, it is 35 characters each, right? Over here, what you see, www.amazon.in, and this URL, this is basically destination URL. So there are two URLs allowed. One is a display URL. We'll come to the window, we'll see it. But I just want to mention it beforehand so that once we see it, it's like a movie coming in front of you and you know what I was talking about earlier. So that once you feed on the background, this headline, and in a tab you will be fitting description one and description two, then the next will be to write down a display URL and a destination URL. Display URL is only for display, so it won't actually make the difference. It will be displayed over here like this, SEO.in. The actual URL, the destination, the landing page, could be anything. So display URL is for how much? 35 characters. And the actual destination URL has no limit, but it has 1024 limit. Yeah, it has 1020 or 1024 limit. So this is the characters which are allowed when it goes to destination. And okay, this is for destination and not for display. Display is only 35. Yeah. So in text ad, you could see headlines, description, which are two, display and destination, and there are a few ad extensions. We'll come to see what are these ad extensions and all. Right? Alright. Now, since we are covering keyword based search as today, let's come to the topic of keywords now. We have also covered this point while doing an SEO, that what and how to determine what could be a good keyword to do. And we have used a few tools. One of this was Keyword Planner. So these are the same relevancies which we're gonna use, but we're gonna talk in detail about evaluating keywords. So we're taking a case for today as pahadi.com only. So we'll be stick around that so that you understand everything. So for example, if you want to promote, let's say, green tea or black tea, Ashalada is trying to promote her that products right now. So she has multiple subcategories into it, green tea, ginger tea, lemon tea, and all that. And she has listed down that as an objective, I should be concentrating on these four or five subcategories or, the products which I want to promote. She'll list it down and she'll try to evaluate how to, put an ad and for what keywords I should do that. And in order to do that, these are the few things which she have to keep in mind. What are those few things she have to keep in mind? She has to keep in mind the relevancy of the keyword. Let's say, for example, she has choice to choose between buy green tea or green tea as a keyword, or a buy green tea as a keyword, or buy green tea in Delhi as a keyword, or green tea in Delhi as a keyword, shopping green tea as a keyword. So she basically has to choose amongst those. So how much relevant it is, there are two ways of going about it, which I have already discussed. That you should have a primary listing of according to your gut feel and checked it out with the end consumers, which you think are the prospective customers. So the best way to determine that is putting yourself into the shoes of the customer, and if in case you can reach primarily to the customers and ask with them what kind of keyword you will like to type if in case you're looking to buy this kind of product. So the relevancy is important. Competition, we can determine it if it's a high, medium, or low, and how many keywords have been used, and in which geographical area, what is the average monthly rate of that keyword being typed and used, that we can check out in through a Google keyword planner. We'll come to that of how to do it. I'm just discussing theoretically that how we are going to cover these 3 points. Search volume is actually very important. So it will be your determination to determine that you want to keywords, target keywords, which are, let's say, on a very high search demand, because you think that that is what is required. Or you can concentrate on medium or, let's say, low keyword search demand. You say it will go waste. It won't be that effective. I'll be paying unnecessarily for those clicks, which ultimately doesn't give me any conversion or traffic. So making a call on that, you make a call that what kind of search volume is okay with you regarding to whatever searches have been done related to your keyword, right? So you determine your keyword based on these parameters. To help it out, we have keyword planner tool, we have customers where we can directly go, we have our gut feel, and we combine all these three and we determine at the end that these are the list of keywords I'll focus upon. Because you have to just keep in mind that this is not an SEO, so it is not only your human effort. The moment you start running a campaign, there will be a great amount of money losing from your pocket, or whatever you have kept for the day, or for the month, or for the campaign. So the searches, if it is not very watertight kind of campaign design, you will end up in losing a big money in waste, right? So clear till here? A point which I want to make, that you have to be very, very specific about the keywords you choose and the effective campaign you write. Ravi, Sangeeta, Shubham, yeah. Achalata, so, okay, now we are coming to, while we choose a keyword, Google AdWords give us three options of looking around for a keyword. And this is very, very important, because again, there is no fixed formula of what way you have to use. I'll come to that, what I'm trying to say. These are called match types. Now, there is no fixed formula of choosing which match type you have to choose, but you have to keep in mind two certain very, very important points. One, what is your end objective and budget you have in hand? What ultimately you want as a result of the campaign? So let's say if I'm a new company being funded, I'm a digital marketer of that company, and my boss has said to me that, Nikhil, your primary job is to get me maximum traffic onto the website. It doesn't matter how many conversions are happening. We will eventually get the conversions sooner or later, but for you, the primary task is you take a Google AdWords account, you run a paid campaign, but I don't know, I want maximum traffic onto the products I'm offering. So I'm offering these tea-oriented products, and for that I want maximum traffic. So I get a greater liberty, and for me, the immediate objective becomes that I should have maximum traffic. In order to have maximum traffic, I concentrate on broad terms, on broad keywords. Like, for example, green tea. Now, green tea is a very broad keyword. Like, green tea in Delhi is a specific kind of keyword. Shopping green tea again becomes a specific keyword, because a green tea can also be searched for, suppose I want to do a weight loss and I'm just exploring different options in doing that. So I type green tea and I put it on a, let's say, on a broad search base. So I have three, going broad, specific, and exact. I'll come to what I'm trying to say. These are three. So if I keep it on a broad keyword search, I'm telling AdWords that you keep it very broad. So I get a result which are not only oriented towards green tea, can only be for tea or only for green. So I can get that kind of search results also. If somebody is looking for, let's say green bag, so there is the possibility that I could get that. I could also get a few synonyms. For example, a lemon tea can also result in, for the ad which I have done. So if somebody searches for lemon tea, that could be a chance that my green tea also pops up, that ad also pops up over there. So if I'm keeping it very broad, I'm increasing the window to come over here, and it's all kind of combinations can come before, after of the keyword and all that. So that is one. Yeah. So I'm just writing on the chat window so you understand. A plus and then writing green tea means that you are allowing things to be before plus, I mean, additions of green tea. So it can be anything, green tea shopping, green tea this, green tea that, and all that. So your keyword was green tea. It in itself was a very broad kind of keyword. And then you have, by default, it is always plus, right? I'll also let you know how it happens. So if you go onto the keywords and see, basically, once we start running a campaign, then I'll show, because you have to choose the campaign and the adword, ad group. But let's say I'm typing like this. So if I'm typing green tea and I'm saying that for this particular campaign, use the little, it's a broad. Or if I do this, it will become a broad, right? My second option is if I type specific, yeah. So what happens is in specific, it becomes that will be specific to green tea. So there will not be any lemon tea coming up, you know, or any tea, only tea as in coming up. So it will only come once the keyword which has been queried for in the search tab have green tea. So it can have good green tea, better green tea, that kind of keywords are also there, right? Or let's say if I've typed buy green tea, so I'm allowing the Google search to pick the search queries and show my ad, which I have kept it for this keyword as buy green tea, to even display when, let's say, somebody search for buy buy cheap green tea. Yeah, you could see that my, this was buy green tea keyword which I selected. So in between over here, this is a new word which I've come down. So since even this will be considered, but it will be specific. There will not be like lemon tea and all that, you know, which is not related to, and only tea will not be picked if in case it was in the case of broad keyword. A third one is exact. Let's say if somebody search for only buy green tea, then only I should be propped up so that if somebody clicks on that, I'm ready to pay you. But I'm only ready to pay you, Mr. Google, when somebody search for this buy green tea. So in order to be very, very precise and specific, I can put it in these close commas or close brackets. And this is how. So the top one over here is a broad keyword match type. This one is specific, but better than broad, but not very exact. And this is exact. Without any special characters will be treated as by default broad one. So if in case you write only green tea, it will by write this, it will be treating it as plus green tea only. So it will be treating it as broad one only, right? So I'm just writing it again so that there is no confusion. This is very important actually. Broad match type. This one is specific match type. And this one is set match type. Got it? Everybody got it? Probably green tea could not be the best example to consider. There could be other examples. Any recommendation on when to use it? Yes, I'll tell you. For me, I will always say that it is better you should not use broad match type anyway, because whatever product or stage of the company you are in, at the end of the day, any keyword will have too much of wastage when you go to broad match type. So you can think of any product, you will see that it is not only that if you are an e-commerce company, that the people who are inquiring only for to convert or only looking to buy that product. No, there are various reasons why we do that, right? So let's not focus around broad too much. We could only do once we feel that, you know, we want to have a great traffic, and we believe that even broad match type queries will ultimately land up to our purpose, which we want, and our website is more than enough to cater them. So then only use broad, otherwise try to use specific and match type. I don't know why, but I really prefer, I'll tell you that I prefer specific match types, because it gives you a liberty to have a one or two keywords in between also. So if somebody is not writing exactly buy green tea or any such, you know, you'll get a little liberty to give it a shot. So specific match type is one thing which I recommend always. Exact is also very precise, so it's up to you. But if you believe that your keyword is watertight and, you know, people are more or less. And there is also one more point. It's not that in a campaign or in an ad group, you'll only be using one keyword. So you can use a combination of 10, 15 keywords, right? Or 20 keywords. So you can use any keywords however you want it. So it is not that you can only use one keyword per campaign, right? So once you go with many keywords, you'll see that even exact keyword is not required, because you're anyway using various combinations out of it, right? But if you, like, we have run a test for this example only, green tea or tea, in a keyword planner tool, and we had seen that there are various keywords. There are keywords more than 100, 800, 500, 1000 keywords. So to choose a 15-20 amongst that is also a task in itself. You may have few negative keywords which you don't want it, but again, so what I recommend is go specific at least to start with, and once you get hands-on with how to use Google AdWords, you can see your result and you could see your CTR rate going high. CTR is click-through rate. I'll tell you what is CTR, but understand that if it is showing in the result and is somebody clicking that. So the more people click based on how many times it is shown, the better rating you have, a CTR rating. The better rating you have, you will be considered by Google AdWords to show efficiently. So it is very, very important for you to have a good watertight campaigns, right? And in order to do that, don't go with broad match type in the starting. This is what I recommend. Go with specific. But then you will get hands-on to it while using it quite regularly, that you will be in a better position than me or anybody else suggesting you what to do. You yourself in a better position to decide what to go about it. All right, Ravi, clear, Sangeeta, Shubham. Yeah, I'll come to that, Ashlata. I'll come to exactly what is CTR once we try to cover CTR. Yeah, it is click through rate. Just in answer to your query, I've used that word, though I was not willing to use that word right now because you'll get confused. Yeah. All right. All right. So let us start doing a campaign. Once we start doing a campaign, this story will come in front of us, what all we have discussed. So I'm deleting it from here. If you click it on to the home, this is the dashboard. This will only result when you, once a campaign is running down, and you see that the figures are coming up over here. There is no effective campaign running down, that's why there is. So you just click on campaigns onto the navigation bar. Our navigation bar always has these 5-6 tools: home, campaigns, opportunities, reports which you want to fetch, tools like keyword planner and conversion tool, and linking it with Google Analytics will do everything. And a billing section is not coming probably because of this band. So there is another navigation bar thing which comes as billing. So you can see your account and billing details from here. So let's say I want to run a new campaign for Pahadi Tea. So I go over there. Out of these six windows, I'm just letting you know again, I would have in the past also, but just for your reference, I'm doing it again. Once you like this, like these shopping ads, if you want to place this ad, where you can go and do, you have to go and click on to the shopping thing. So product listing ad, this is called product listing ad. This will come over here. This is done through another mediocre in between, which is called Google Merchant. So in Google Merchant, there you have to list down your product. You have to list down your product with the image, with the URL, with the price and all that. And then it will be displayed over here. We'll cover that in detail afterwards. But right now we're focusing on keyword search ad. So let's click on search network only. And you could see that it will give us a window to start making a campaign and start making an ad. So there is one thing which you have to understand, which I haven't told you. Okay, let me go to once again to this. You could see over here that it is a campaign, then ad groups. So there can be a question, what is campaign, what is ad group, yeah, and what is keyword. So you imagine it like a tree. On the top, it's campaign. So basically, or let's say imagine from beneath, imagine from root, that you have a keyword. So what you're doing is, if she wants to run a campaign, Ashalata wants to run a campaign, and she wants to run a campaign, let's say, on her tea wala section. On her tea, she have various buy type teas, I mean different types of tea, black, green, white, oolong, chai, herbal, iced tea and all that. Now she wants to run a campaign, and for that she has chosen, selected, let's say 15-20 keywords. Now it will be her wish to run different ads under one campaign. So she is running, let's say, a winter campaign, a February oriented campaign, where she is focusing more on awareness. This is her objective. Initial push is her objective. She's only focusing, let's say, on Delhi NCR and northern markets like Punjab and all this. This is her main device of the campaign. But she wants to treat a black tea campaign as separate and green tea campaign as separate, but overhead it will be under one big campaign, right? So sabse low mein jo hai wo keywords hai, us keywords ki combination se aap different ad groups bana sakte hain under one campaign. So if she is running one campaign today, she can make a different ad group for black tea based on her different specification of keywords. She can make a different ad group for green tea, for white tea and all that. So this gives her permission. Google AdWords give us an advantage of making a campaign, a big campaign with a combination of different ad groups. Right, and in different ad groups we can have different keywords, a combination of different keywords. Got it till here? So you can have a one big campaign when you could have different type of ads coming under it, but it will be clubbed under one campaign so that you can analyze it quite effectively and run it and execute it quite effectively. Shubham, Sangeeta, NK, Ashalata, got it? You'll also have it a good hands-on once we start running it, right? but it should be theoretically clear and should not be very confusing what any word comes. That is why I'm displaying it while letting you know right now. So what you do is you make a big start running a big campaign, right? A big running campaign. There is a campaign name. Once I do a training session in the last, or I have also seen various trainers to keep it like this only, because for them it's only a testing thing. But I would not recommend you to ever, even whenever you run a campaign, run like this, campaign 3, campaign 4. Because once you start running an effective campaign, you'll see that your dashboard will have many campaigns and many ad groups and many, many keywords, right? So you'll get confused once you revisit that campaign 4. So try to mention it in a nice order, which you can also comprehend and understand and quickly see to it once you go through again onto the dashboard to check out your campaign, right? So you can have your order, whatever you feel like, Acharada, Sangeeta, Shubham, or Ravi, NK. You can have your choice of putting what is best for you. A few recommendations from my side could be that, first of all, name the main objective so that you understand that. Like, for example, first campaign. So you can write down that it was your first campaign, or awareness campaign. You can name anything like that. Then put a dash. Try to put a month so that easily remembers. Try to put a product that it is for more or less green tea. So whatever you want to put, right? It was for tea sales. That was your objective. So just put it any number that you feel, or any name that you feel that you will be easily able to understand it, right? So put that name to the campaign like that, right? Okay. Then by default it will be on the standard one, but you can choose all features also. With all features, whatever parallel features it had, so it will be. So let's say we put T in Delhi NCR. Now that is my primary focus, and I put it like that. So moving down, it gives you an option of picking out details from any existing campaign which you have done last, and you can, so you need not to fill all the details over here, location and all that, target and all that. So you can just pick out from the existing campaigns. These were the test campaigns which I have run, so you can just forget it. We'll try to fill each and every detail, right? All right. Amongst network, it gives you a choice of choosing amongst the Google search network or that. So we are choosing anyways by default Google search network. So it will cover not only a Google in itself, but also its partner sites which are taking help of Google search. So it will cover that also. Devices will show in all. So it is better that you should keep it on all, because right now there is a good combination of mobiles and tablets being used, not only desktops. So let it be an all right now. And then you have choice to choosing it onto the different locations. You can choose it for the whole damn world, or you can choose it for the country, or you can also choose it for the precise. Like, for example, we have mentioned on onto the campaign name that we are only focusing on Delhi NCR, so I can focus on Delhi. And let's say I want to focus on Punjab, so I can focus on Punjab, India. And let's say I want to focus on Bangalore and Hyderabad too, for some strange reasons, and I want to advertise over there also. So if somebody searches from Bangalore, I will get that, and if somebody searches from Hyderabad, I will get that too. Yeah. So you can choose on precisely what cities and what, you know, it will also give you an expected reach figure also over here. Now there is one thing over here which I want to mention. You can also go to the advanced and choose a very specific. a very specific, like for example, if I have a store in Gurgaon, right? And I only want to cover a few kilometer radius of Gurgaon. So I can just type Gurgaon. So it will cover that. It will cover, see, you can see that map is coming, and I want to set down on a radius. And from the center of the Gurgaon, I only want to cover, let's say, 8 kilometer radius. And let's say in Gurgaon, so you could see that I've written down the specific area, specific exact location, and then I've also given it a radius, that around, if my store is around that area, I'll write down the specific area and I'll try to put a kilometer radius, so that will be specifically around, if a search has been made specifically from that area, it will be covered, right? Can try it for any other location as well. Can anybody name any location from his or her city? So I'll try to put that and see if it comes. Why not explore that also? So let's put Vashi, Navi Mumbai, and search it down. Like, see, you can see. And now it will be up to me that how many kilometers I want to do. Let's say I want to cover in a radius of 10 kilometers and be covered. Like, right? And then I want to add it. So I can add it. You can see that it has Navi Mumbai area has been covered around that radius. And this is the reach which can be expected around that based on the campaign which we're designing. So got it? This is very important for new businesses, because sometimes you only want to focus a very local area. So Ravi, Sangeeta, Shubha, Mashalata, NK. Yeah. All right. You could see that these are the locations which are 10 kilometers around. Vashi, Navi Mumbai has come, Gurgaon has come, Hyderabad has come, Bangalore has come. And suppose we have filled that, but we want to change it. We don't want, let's say, Gurgaon now, so we can remove Gurgaon. So this we can do, right? I'll recommend you to use advanced searches. Do not only focus around the big areas. Use advanced searches, and that will help you out, right? Then on language, I would suggest to keep it for English only, but again, it depends on the product you are offering, and if you feel strongly that you should cater to a regional language or any other language wherever you're focusing, depending on the which part of the world, you can choose your language as well. So you can go to edit and you can choose it, but for default you should keep it, it is for English, and you can keep it for English as it is. Alright, now comes a very interesting part, which is bid strategy. Right. So we have anyways covered that CPM, CPC and CPA as a short form, which we call for cost per impression, we call it CPM. Cost per click, we call it CPC. And cost per acquisition, we call it CPA. Or it is also cost per customization for conversion, right? And that is why we call it acquisition, because already we had a word called CPC, so it will become confused. So that's why we call it CPA. All right. Now what
you can keep it to the manual and try putting that, but for the initial basis I'll recommend you to let AdWords do the thinking part for it, and you put a daily budget for it, right? So you can put, let's say, a day budget of rupees 100 for this, and if you do it manually you have to give it a default bid for it. And let's say you feel, based on your planner tool, keyword planner tool which you have used, and you have filtered down the keywords and you have seen how many, you know, the average rate is going around, and let's say you have filtered down that your keyword will go around 7-8 rupees and you have put it as 7 rupees, so you can do that. Yeah, so if you're doing it manually, you have to put two things. You have to put a per bid, a per click rate, and you also have to put a day budget. But once you do an automatic, then what is going to be the bid amount, Google AdWords or Google ultimately will decide upon itself. So they will decide. So then it could be an end. So there will not be an upper limit to the bidding amount, right? So if in case to get you a click, if they believe that rupees 40 is suitable, so they can bid around 40. But exactly this is not how it happens. Whosoever is the highest bidding around that time, it will remain around that time only, on that bandwidth only, right? So it is not that it will haywirely gonna put any amount. So in fact, Google has a better understanding and a better service to give you. So got my point? Till here, how to put a bid strategy? Achha, in bid strategy, there are two additional points which I want to mention here. Number one is, like, you can see on whenever you're going to put your daily budget, you could see a very small line written over here. Actually, day spend may vary. Yeah. So what does that mean? Any guesses? Ravi, Sangeeta, Shubham, let's make it interactive. Any guesses? What does that mean? Ashalata, Babu, Karthikeyan, Antu. First of all, why have they written that? What is the purpose of writing it down? Does they really do that? And if they do that, to how many percentage does they vary? Make a guess, please. Shubham says no idea. Andrew says competition, right? Due to competition, this is happening. But what does that mean? I'll tell you what does that mean. Let Google figure it out. Yes, Achalata, Google will figure it out. See, what you are doing, let's again try to understand what we are doing by filling these details. What we are doing exactly, once we come on to the bidding strategy, we say is that either we are going to choose manually, that, you know, per bid, per click, per auction, per bid, this is the maximum which you could go. So if you are writing it down, let's say rupees, for example, rupees 5. So what I'm saying is, whenever the auction for this keyword happens, whenever somebody queries for this keyword for which I'm making a campaign, and out of the competition, the bidding automatically happens in at the background, and in that, the maximum you can go, Mr. Google, is 5 rupees. If somebody has bid rupees 6, give it to them. I'm not bothered about it. If somebody bid for 3, then make me considerable. So for my highest, if second highest is, let's say, 3 rupees, I'll become the highest of, let's say, 3.10, then my thing will be chosen, but I will go to the maximum of 5 rupees. So this is what I'm saying, either by doing it manually or letting it Google decide for itself, so whatever way. The second is, I'm also putting a day budget. I'm saying whatever happens at the end of the day, I should not be spending more than rupees 100. So it keeps me under my budgets. Right, so I can write down any budget. I can keep 25,000 to 2,50,000 to 25 lakh rupees as a day budget. But whatever that day budget is, Mr. Google, you're not allowed to cross that. Now what happens is, Google has a bigger responsibility, and that bigger responsibility is to show your ad to the world, to the relevant people who are searching for it, and also earn out of it. And give you a better results, right? And the more you do that, the more you're gonna add, and the more the better it will be. What happens is, he has taken or Google has taken a day budget, but sometimes it feels that in order to give you a better result with the, you know, automatic bidding on the, for the per, you know, per transaction going on, it may crosses rupees 100 also sometimes. But for that, Google has kept a cap that it in eventually it will not happen on a month, on a, if you count a whole month, but for a daily basis, he is taking a liberty of crossing to the maximum of 20%. So for example, if I've kept rupees 100, that means for 30 days, my budget will comes out to be how much? How many rupees? I thought I am bad in maths. If my day budget is 100, my monthly budget will be 3600. Ravi, you are my bro, man. You are my brother. It is 3000, man. Right? So if my day budget is 100 rupees, 30 into 100 will be like 3000 rupees. Oh yes, with 20%, yes. But this is what I'm coming to, Ravi. For a day, Google will, can spend up to, in any day, can spend up to the maximum of, okay, then you are better in maths, at least from my, from me, yeah. Congrats. Now, Ravi, and everybody else, for per day, Google can spend at the maximum of 120 rupees. But they won't spend on a span of a month, in any given month, more than 3000 rupees. So they are eventually promising, giving you what they are promise, but they're taking a little liberty of going in a in few days where they feel that they can give you a better result, right? So what, in any given day that they can go to a maximum of 120 rupees, but they will not go for a month anywhere even a rupee more than rupees 3000. Got it? Since it's a little math trivia going on, let me give you a little more edge to it. Can anybody divide 365 by 12 and let me know what the answer is? Ravi, I'm expecting a good response from you because Achalata, Sangeeta, Shubham. Are you sure? Okay, let us do little Excel sheet also. Divided by 12. So it is 30.4. 4-1 is like you can divide, you can make it on a single as 30.4, right, Shubham? So what happens is, in the algorithm you would see that they won't count a month, or any other such machine which is working at the background will never count a month as 30 days. Will always count month as 30.4 days, right? So our budget will become 100 into 30.4. Ravi, quickly, how much? ₹3040. So friends, actually my monthly budget is ₹3040, not 3000 rupees. Got it? We have 365 days in total. If we have 12 months in a year, it actually becomes 30.4 days and not 30 days as such. So when they calculate money regarding to 1 month, they will calculate basis on that. So my budget becomes 3040 and not 3000. So everybody clear till here? Bidding strategies and you know how much amount per month, what is the liberty and all that, right? All right. Let us go, Ravi, that it is clear. Okay. Let us click on advanced options. Okay, this include conversions and audit. Thanks, Mukesh. Let us leave it for now. This will cover once we cover conversions. Okay, then there are ad extensions. We can cover it afterwards, but I'll give you a glimpse of ad extensions. What are ad extensions? Let us see if we can, case we have that. Let us type Google AdWords and see if they give. Yes. Now what we see over here, these locations coming down, right? These are called ad extensions. Up to here we have a normal ad with a home URL and then the description. But we see below that, you would see that they put an offer section over here, the order, the section over here, location and all that. Now these are called ad extensions. How to come into that position? This is how we'll come into that. So we can expand by adding a location. So it is saying that your account doesn't have any location, so we can add locations. If we add location, that location display will come over here, right? We can also put a phone number for a towards calling it, so we can put a call. We can put some site links to it, subsections of the sites and all that, right? So we can have a few ad extension if in case we want to have that. Got it, friends? Clear till here? Ravi, Sangeeta, Shubham. Okay. Then save and try to move forward. Okay, now it is asking for to create an ad group. We have made one campaign which was on the top of the tree. Below it we can have various ad groups, and then below it we can have various keywords. So we're going with that structure. We have made one master, fill the details of the master campaigning. Now I am filling the URL page. Let's say my URL is fahadat.com/whatever page I want to put. I'm putting it as a home page right now, so I can put whatever URL I want to do with it. And you could see that it is scanning the, by automatically it doesn't only scan that, it went to the page, the landing page, and based on the content which was there in the landing page, Google has given you a little suggestions on the keywords here only, right? So it is helping you out all the way while putting an ad. So sometimes we may not require it, because we have already done. I'm just assuming, because we have covered using a keyword planner tool, so I haven't got it today. If in case you want me to again revisit the keyword planner tool, I can, but since we have already covered, I'm not doing that. So I'm assuming that when you're designing a campaign, you have done your homework first. First of all, you need to run a keyword planning tool, and then you have to come up with the list of final list of keywords which you want to portray for the landing page. Right, so after that we need to do whatever we are doing today. So we already have a list, we already have keywords, so we need not require to have these suggestions, but it's most welcome. Once we are done that, we could also take these suggestions. Now ad group, again in the ad group I would recommend not to put like ad group 1, ad group 5, ad group, no, put a specific ad group. That ad group can be for India, T for India, let's say for February campaign. So I can, whatever way I want to put it. It is okay, and then I start writing down keywords. Once I start writing down keywords, I would request you to put the keywords one beneath other. No commas, no spaces, nothing. So put one keyword, like for example, green tea. If I'm doing it by default, I'm actually trying to do it like this. So I'm putting it out broad. So I can have various combinations. Let's say I want to write down buy green tea, and I want to put it as in a specific. So I can put it in a specific, right? So loose tea leaf, loose tea leaf buy online. What are these keywords called? The full keyword, these are called keyword phrases. So green tea is one keyword phrase, buy green tea is another keyword phrase, loose tea leaf buy online, this is one tea phrase, keyword phrase, right? So these are key phrases. I'm just writing it out randomly. I'm not recommending you to write it this way. Asharada, please do not get confused. And everybody else also, do not get confused. I've taken case only to demonstrate an example, and I'm just writing down next tempo. So I'm not recommending you to, if you're, you know, putting an ad for this kind of website and these are the keyword you should take. Use your intelligence, your understanding, and of course keyword planner tool ka help low. और वहां पर अप्रोच करो जहां पर आपको लगता है यू हैव अ डोमेन टू और एन एरिया और एन अ बैटलफील्ड टू डू इट. वेर एवर यू थिंक देर इज बिग कॉम्पिटिशन, अ हैवी कीवर्ड लाइक ग्रीन टी, बहुत ज्यादा ऑक्यूपेंसी है, फॉरगेट इट, डू नॉट स्पेंड इट. उसको एसईओ में लाने की कोशिश करो, विच इज नॉट वेरी एक्सपेंसिव, बट डू नॉट डू इट इन एडवर्ड्स, बिकॉज इफ यू गोना डू इट इन एडवर्ड्स यू विल, आपको पता चलेगा कि आपका बजट जो है वो बहुत ही जल्दी खत्म हो गया, आई मीन, और आपको कोई बेनिफिट नहीं हुआ. Right, wherever the competition is low, wherever you have a long phrase and a better phrase and something where the, like for example, Ashalata, yours is an e-commerce site, right? And an e-commerce site, your purpose is if the customer is more or less ready to buy that, or into the very last stage of inquiries and just looking to explore, and if in case he likes it, he'll extempo gonna buy it and impulsively gonna buy it, then use keywords like buy green tea, because that is what they are going to search. They're not going to search green tea anymore. Your customer will search buy green tea, online green tea in USA, in case you are marketing in USA, green tea in Delhi, delivery of green tea, these type of keywords they're going to search, right? So try to understand what they would be searching and at what advanced longer phase they will be in a stage to fill that. Got it? Ravi, Achalata, Sangeeta, Shubham, Anto, Karthikeyan, KP, yeah? Now you have advantage of adding more ad groups, you can, or you can just give it like that and then continue to add. And here it comes. Abhi bride or bridegroom ko jaise sajate hain shaadi mein, ab hum wahan pe pahunch gaye. उनके लिए सारी शॉपिंग कर ली हमने, वेन्यू डिसाइड कर लिया, सब हो गया खाना वाना. अब अल्टीमेटली वी आर ऑन टू द ब्राइड एंड ब्राइड ग्रूम स्टेज, एंड वी विल राइट डाउन व्हाट एग्जैक्टली वी वांट देम टू बी लुकिंग लाइक एट द डे ऑफ द मैरिज, राइट? सो लेट अस पुट द एड कंटेंट्स एंड ऑल दैट, एंड यू कुड सी दैट यू हैव द प्रीव्यू ऑफ हाउ इट्स गोना कम. सो
Now this is, I'll leave it all up to you. Tell me what, how the ad should be coming, like taking the TV example, and give me an headline for it. Maximum, you know, guys, 25 letters are allowed. So just drop it. Drop me a headline, please. Premium quality tea. And yes, it is not Ashara that I'm asking. Yeah, so everybody can write it. So premium. I'll also recommend my recommendations, right? Once I'll write it down. Premium quality tea. Yeah. So here you have to understand, it's very good that Asha Lata has given a different example and Shubham has given a different example, and both are relevant, but both have their own plus and minuses. One thing you have to understand, that the search from the consumer end has already gone. Abhi wo sari baatein hum kar chuke hain. So what is more savvy, you know, ye search karne par ye aa jayega, wo wali sari stage ho chuki hai, because it is happening through a keyword kind of thing. It is not linked with whatever we are displaying over here. Try and understand. The only relevancy is your headline great enough to catch the eyeball of the person who has searched for the keywords which you have written down in last, jo humne 3 keywords likhe the ya jahan pe hum 15-20 keywords likhne wale the. Let's say we have written 15-20 keywords. Abhi wo keyword search kara aur mere paas ad dikhega. आ गया पेज पर, SERP पे आ गया, सर्च इंजन रिजल्ट पेज पर आ गया. अब SERP पे आने के बाद now it is like a cosmetic thing. Now it is like to catch the eyeball, right? Okay, Sangeeta is asking a question. Green tea. No, Sangeeta, this is what I'm saying. Call extension we have just covered, Karthikeyan, on the last, but I'll complete the cycle and then I'll let you know how to cover it. I'll let you know again, because abhi main peeche jaunga to everything will go haywire. So I'll let you know how to add a call extension. I just covered it on the last page, last to last page basically. Yes, I'll let you know. I'll let you know, Karthikeyan. Just be with me. Yeah. Okay. Sangeeta is saying that why not to add green tea or premium quality green tea? You know, why are you just ignoring green tea as a word? Of course, you should include, because this is what the end consumer is looking for. But theoretically, what I'm trying to say, Sangeeta, is it will be your end goal to put whatever you want to put in the headline, right? Now, one thing which you be clear in your mind is that jis keyword ke liye usko dekha gaya hai, wo story abhi complete ho chuki hai. Now it is only an eyeball attraction. In a limited space of writing down a text, what could be an eyeball attraction? So premium, Asharatha feels that the word premium is like a good eyeball attraction. Shubham probably have written that buy online tea or buy tea online is the attraction. You are saying that buy premium quality green tea, this is the attraction. So it is very subjective thing. You can write down whatever you feel like. So premium quality green tea could be another attraction to get the eyeball, right? Or you're saying come down to writing down buy premium. When we write this, it crosses more than 25 characters, so we have to curtail down somewhere. Now we have to make a call where to curtail down, so we can curtail down here also. So whatever you feel like, you can write it down. One recommendation from my side is, try, sometimes numbers plays the magic in e-commerce, right? And if you feel that you have a very competitive rate, then just keep it onto the most forefront you can. And if you see that you are providing a good green tea at a rate which is not competitive, and you see that let's say rupees 30 में मैं ग्रीन टी का पैकेट दे रहा हूँ, जो और कहीं नहीं मिल रही, या हेयर यू कैन यूज यू वर्ड प्रीमियम, सो आई कैन यूज लाइक दिस. Now this is my way of looking into it. I'm not saying that go by this rule, right? Everybody has a different way of approaching marketing and attracting this, right? You can write. So you're the best judge whosoever is doing the campaign for end product, right? So Sangeeta, Shubham, Archalata, Ravi, NK, Karthikeyan. Achha, Karthikeyan, we have done this thing, what you're saying, to put an ad extension with a call name and number. What I'm saying is, we'll cover it again. I'll try to demonstrate it again to you. But since we are on to the further pages, I don't want to disturb the flow. I'll cover it once we have covered with the whole thing. And then I'll again let you know where to do it. Okay, Ashala is saying yes, but in the end they need to buy and how to improve sales today. Yes, see, you have to understand, first you are looking for people who are searching for it, then you are looking for what they will be searching, right? Then if they search, what will come? So you are in a stage when if they search and my ad comes with the competition, because there will be many results in the SERP page. SEO के results भी हैं, आपके results भी हैं और आपके competition के results भी हैं. In order to have that, you should have to make a good attraction that he or she clicks onto your ad. So here we are on a stage where we are trying to attract it, and they clicks onto that and reaches to the landing page where we believe he or she is going to buy it. So that is the reason we are recommending whatever we are recommending. And this is not the final recommendation, it is very subjective. Shivam has its own way of looking into things. You have your own way. Sangeeta has her own way. I have my own way. Just out of experience, I am recommending that sometimes what happens in an e-commerce, if you believe that you have a competitive rate, try to bring it on upfront. Because you will miss a lot of things. People will not know that you are very competitive. But the moment if I have the advantage of that and I can display it on the forefront, and I will tell you, I will throw a challenge, I am selling a premium green tea at 99 rupees where Amazon can't. So I'm taking that to my advantage. So this is my recommendation, but it is not a precise recommendation. You can go to whatever way you want. Right. Now let's get to description. Give me one description, please. Assam and Darjeeling tea. So what basically Ashalada is trying to do is right now is trying to give a whole portfolio into the limits of whatever character she can as an ad. So sad mein wo sab kuch batana chah rahi hai, unhone premium quality ka batane ki koshish kar li. Now she is trying to put, Ravi is recommending try to put low cost high quality kind of line, which is very good. Hair also, try to be little precise. Again, my another recommendation, like for example, low cost and high quality at 20% discount, something like that. At 20% off, right? No, but Ashalata, again, you're taking me wrong. This is an example, a metaphorical example. I'm not recommending you should take it. I'm not recommending for Pahadi tea anything. There is nothing to do with Pahadi tea today. I have to take one case which all you guys are familiar with, and you can have a great pulse of blood going through when you see the session. That is the reason I'm taking this. I'm just only recommending, think it as a normal e-commerce site, a competitive e-commerce site, right? Do not get confused with the exact brand, please. Yeah, Ravi is saying as brand comparison is slow. No, Ravi, I didn't get you what you are recommending to Achalata or recommending to the trainees over here, I mean the panel over here. So what I'm trying to show over here is that I'm just taking an example, so you can write it down any way you like to do it, right? Now here comes display URL, and if we are going with Pahadi T, let's say for example she has a URL called green tea, she can do it like that. Okay, now there are two URLs which you can see here. It is a display URL. It has nothing to do with the ultimate landing page. Ultimate landing page will come over here. So if somebody clicks that, this is where he or she will be taken to. So write down the exact address over here. It can be whatever. So let me pick it up. Here. This is for the cosmetic thing, that if somebody sees the ad will see this thing like that. So if you easily someone maps that way up quick or visibility multi. Right? And then you click on create ad. There is the ad, you can see. तो चेंजेस कर सकते हैं जो भी आप करना चाहो बाय गोइंग ऑन टू एडिट एंड यू कैन अगेन चूज इट. हियर आर द कीवर्ड्स व्हिच यू हैव चोजन एंड चेंज द कीवर्ड्स. यू कैन रिव्यू द कैंपेन एंड मेक द चेंजेस और यू क्लिक एंड सेव एंड फिनिश एंड स्टार्ट फिनिशिंग इट. हियर इज हाउ इट हैज कम. And if you look on, it will be under review right now. But if you look over here, you will see that you could able to see the basic results. The default maximum cost per click, which you have set as ₹5. How many clicks have happened? How many impressions were there? What was CTR? Now let me come to CTR and the importance of CTR. CTR is click through rate, and it has a formula of how many clicks have actually happened divided by total impressions. So if your ad was, let's say, displayed for example 100 times, right? So its impressions are 100 and it was clicked, let's say, 5 times. So CTR will become how much? Ravi, Sangeeta, Shubham, 20. So it will become 20%. All right. And now comes the very important part. Very important for any advertiser, any digital marketing advertiser who is practicing Google AdWords heavily. CTR is just not only a figure. CTR is the basis on which Google decides they want to show your ad or don't want to show your ad. If you have a bad click CTR, they would not, even if you bid high, they will not show your ad. Because at the end of the day, it is like a bad recommendation. It is like, मैं अपने दोस्त से हर बार पूछता हूँ यार कोई अच्छा खाने की जगह बता दे, और वो मेरे को जो भी जगह बताता है घटिया ही बताता है. चौथी बार के बाद मैं उससे पूछने बंद कर दूंगा. सो एज अ यूजर, इफ गूगल इज दैट फ्रेंड, आई गो एंड आस्क एंड इट गिव्स मी अ बैड बैड प्लेस टू सजेस्ट बैड सजेशन विच आई डोंट वॉन्ट, आई वोंट कंसिडर गूगल. सो गूगल वॉन्ट टू मेंटेन its credibility, its reputation in the market, and in order to do that, he has allowed you to pay him and make an ad but has created a criteria. And in criteria, it doesn't say that you bid highest and take the ad. No, it keep you under the check. Under earlier, it was only CTR. Now it is quality score. Quality score. What exactly is the combination of quality score? Nobody knows. उनके अपने बहुत ही कॉम्प्लेक्स एल्गोरिथम्स हैं जिससे वो डिसाइड करते हैं कितनी बार कब दिखाई गई ऐड, क्यों हुआ, कैसे हुआ, क्या उसको रेटिंग क्लिक्स मिल रहे हैं, कितने लैंडिंग्स मिल रहे हैं, कितने कन्वर्जन मिल रहे हैं, सबकी कॉम्बिनेशन से दे डिसाइड अपॉन अ क्वालिटी स्कोर. बट दिस इज समहाउ बीन फाउंड आउट दैट इन क्वालिटी स्कोर CTR इज द मेन क्राइटेरिया. वट कैन दीज कुड बी दी अदर क्राइटेरियाज, what is the ultimate combination, ultimate formula, nobody knows, but CTR has a significant role, this we know. So this is why I'm recommending that your campaign should be watertight. Do not just pick random keywords. It is not that you're spending money, you're not only wasting money on the campaign, you're wasting money for the future campaign as well, because आपको अच्छी रेटिंग नहीं मिलेगी, आपको अच्छी प्रिविलेज नहीं मिलेगी, आपको टॉप एड्स में भी नहीं आ पा पाओगे. सो यू हैव टू बी वेरी गुड इन ऑर्डर टू चूज द कैंपेन्स, द कीवर्ड्स एंड मेक अ स्पेसिफिक एड ग्रुप सो दैट यू नो एंड मेक अ गुड कॉपी, मेक एन इफेक्टिव एड लाइक वी हैव डिस्कस्ड. एंड आई वॉज रियली ग्लैड दैट यू गाइज वर पुटिंग रियल एफर्ट इन राइटिंग डाउन व्हाट डिस्क्रिप्शन शुड बी देयर, व्हाट प्रीमियम, व्हाट हेडलाइन शुड बी देयर, how it should be craft, what should be there, what should not be there. Try to do that very effectively with every ad, because at the end of the day, CTR is one account. Yeah. And let's say if you want to see the quality score over here only in the panel itself. So where you can go and add that, these are the columns, right? So we have multiple columns and we can just go to modify columns and pick whatever we want to pick. So impression are already there, average CPC, quality role is not, reviews, wait. Okay, we are in ad groups. We have to go to keywords. Modify. Quality score. So you can just add quality score and see that quality score has come over here. Well, if you click on apply, you could see that the quality score has come 6 out of 10. If we go to the status, we'll be able to see the quality score for a particular keyword over here also. But it should be displaying here. I don't know why. Quality score is here. You could see that the quality score has come over here, 6 out of 10 and all that. So quality score per keyword has come. And you can also go and check it out. like this with the recommendations. And once the campaign starts running, it will go up and down. So clear till here. Sangeeta, Shubham, Ravi, NK, Ashalata, Anto, Babu, Karthike, and KP. Everybody understood? How to check out the report, what are the important attributes, how to put an ad, how to put an effective ad rather. Alright, this is one part which we have covered. In fact, we have covered more or less a good significant thing right now in AdWords, but we'll try to cover display ads and the shopping based merchandise ad, but I'm not sure because for that we need to create a merchant account. I don't know if I'll be able to do that, but I'll try to do that. And then a YouTube based ad, which we have already done, but I'll do a quick recap also so that nothing missed out in Google AdWords. So any doubts till here, any questions you want to put through, or anything which is you want to put it on the table for recommendation, for suggestion, any doubt which you have in mind, anything related to strategy, nothing. Show me saying CPI, what CPI cost per? CPI, you mean to say cost per impression? Is it Shubham? Okay. The abbreviation which we use for cost per impression is CPM. Because you will get confused. Otherwise, you will be using CPM. You are using CPI. So use CPM, right? No, it's okay. Okay, let me say it so that you don't feel guilty. But these abbreviations are bullshit. Either you should be using full name. So even if you are using abbreviations, do not be concerned that the other is using another abbreviation and I'm using. I'm just letting you know so that if you talk to other people in your trade in digital marketing, then communication a ground pe nahi ho payega. That is why. So don't be sorry or don't be like thinking about it. You can use it anything, right? I personally hate these abbreviations. I don't want to use it because it is purposeless. So main kisi ko kuch bhi bol sakta hu, in 2 minutes kuch bhi bol. Yes, we can use that in particular pin codes. Once we humne wo jo advanced wala wo dekha tha, advanced search location, where we can use that. I'll try to use particular pin code, but I haven't used it. But if you focus it on 1 kilometer, 2 kilometer, you are ultimately trying more or less to use in particular pin codes. But can we do it in a very, very particular pin code? I try to run that. I have no idea, Karthikeyan, because I haven't run that campaign on that. But let me do. Okay. Shubham, I'll come to your question. First, I'll just try to cover this. I'll try to check it out on both the questions. Let's say for example campaign 3, let's let it be named like this only. So we go to this. And we go to advanced search. And let's say we are looking for a pin code. Karthikeyan, can you give me a pin code? Yes, so I can add this. You could see that it is covering only this pin code with a reach of 223,000 people. So we can add this. Once you do that, you can see that it has been added over here. If you want to remove, you can remove. I have no idea, I have to check it out. Give me a latitude and longitude in that case. आई गेस मैप पे क्लिक करने से भी हो जाएगा। सो यू कैन नैरो इट डाउन एंड डू इट दिस, यू कैन एक्सप्लोर इट आफ्टरवर्ड्स शुभम, कि वो लैटिट्यूड लॉन्गिट्यूड लेगा नहीं लेगा। डू इट एट एज एज वंस यू आर प्रैक्टिसिंग, राइट? डू दैट। No idea, I need to dig it out because I haven't searched by that case. We need to search it down and check it out if in case giving a precise location we can do that or not. So for latitude longitude, you at your as a homework and I as my homework will try to find it out if in case that's possible. Okay, let's oh yeah, then I have to go to Google Map and find it out. You can just find it out, Shubham. Yes, I know that we can search it down the location and try to put our locations. But let's not do that right now. There are various other questions we need to fill it. We can do it afterwards and come up with the next session which we'll be taking, that is it doable or not, because there will be various R&D we need to do. Yeah. So I'm just making an exit from here. And try to answer the bidding strategy one. I'll just get back to you on the, because I've whatever campaign I've run and always run on CPC, so I've never run on cost per impression. I have to find it out and let you know. So these are the two things remaining. How to run a CPM one, and if just take the precise location with latitude and longitude. All right. Any more query? Ashalata, you are not allowed to go till the time you fill this feedback form. And it is for everybody else also. We are about to end the session. Please fill the feedback form along with the comments. That is really helpful. So display Anto, it is like not only the keyword based text result, but it will also display an image into that. We'll cover that in the next thing, next session when we cover. So one is only keyword based and the other is display ad. And then there is shopping product listing ad, then there is YouTube based video ad. So there are five or six options which we get in Google AdWords to promote out of its Google whole network, which it have maps, which have YouTube, which has Google search. These are various byproducts of Google. Amongst the Google partner sites, we can do that, Karthikeyan. We'll cover display ads in the next session in detail, so don't worry about that. And try to run keyword based ad in the meanwhile. Please do that. the more you do that, the better you will get the answers. Through AdSense, you become a part of Google AdWords, Google Partner Sites. And once you become a Google Partner Sites, see, advertisement has two mediums. One, the supply side, the other, the advertiser side. So if you are a host of a site where you want the ads to come and you want to earn parallelly, and you try to come into the kitty of Google Partner Sites, so you can do that. What happens is, a third party, for example, Anto is promoting a brand, and if it is displayed in Karthikeyan's site, Google will take a transaction in between and pass it on some monies to Karthikeyan and give and take money from Anto. What we have done is we have seen that Anto is promoting an ad right now. So it is how advertisers do. And there is the other sites where you become the host and you earn out of it. Same way you do for YouTube also. Achha, Anto is saying still you haven't got. I'm so sorry, friends. I've promised you guys last time that I'll talk to DMP guys to give you a website. But I'm really very sorry. I just missed out. It was a very occupying week in my office. So I couldn't able to do that. I've just kept out of my mind. Since you have reminded me, I'll write it down in my diary. And I'll, whenever I'm going to talk next, maybe tomorrow only. So I'll talk to them tomorrow about the websites. And why don't anyone can just remind me also to talk to them again. So I'll talk to them. Okay, Shivam is saying, this is what I said, this is very subjective. I would recommend a low search to recommend in the initial basis. Shivam. Hi. If you're doing an SEO, do not ignore a high search keyword because eventually it will pay down. For an AdWords, since you'll be spending a lot of money and you want an immediate result on the money you will be spending, try to concentrate on long phrases and low search keywords. That will be my recommendation. But it is quite subjective. We'll get to know once we do that for that particular category and how the searches are happening, what are the ultimate response we are getting. So there is no fixed formula, but it is better that you should, I recommend to do this that way. Please fill the feedback form, and once you're done, write down that. KP saying Paathshala means KP school in Hindi. So it is Paathshala. Again, I was super from Google Ads. This I need to check. I haven't checked. I'm not sure about the coupons on this. I'll just check it out and be prepared for the next session. Good night, Ravi. Thanks, Shubham. So please fill the feedback form. Do write your comments, and then we can make an exact. Bye, Shubham. Bye bye. Good night. Thanks, Angita. Thanks for your feedback. Thank you, Anto. Kathigan said, I want to do AdWords to my product. Can you help me out on that? I'd love to do that. In fact, I'll do that. But with me, you have to bear a little indiscipline that because I'm really really occupied these days, Karthikeyan. So you can just I'll try to help you out in that. Give me the details. My number you may have that. I'll try to do best what I can, but I can't promise you right how my results, how my inputs will be. These are my results. Mail me up with your details, whatever inputs you want me to give, and I'll try to give that. Sure, why not? Babu, please fill the feedback form. Along with your comments, please do write comments as well. And to Karthikeyan. Okay. KP, please fill. Yeah, thanks Karthikeyan. Let us meet next week. NK, KP, Sangeeta, you already filled that. So how did you find this agent, Nikhil? From my site, boomtrainers.com. What digital marketing I should start? Okay, I'll just check out the site, Sangeeta, and I'll get back to you with the response. I'll try to give you suggestions to best of my capacity. Let's see if it works out. But I tell you, out of a thumb rule to get people registrations is newsletter. Try to bring in newsletter plugin into the site. And there are various good plugins which not only focuses on newsletters but try to build around a story for, you know, having maximum registrations. So I'll recommend you a few plugins. Try to bring that up in case you finally decide to do it. Take your final call on whatever suggestions you get from me or anybody else, and that could give you a maximum registrations. Now what happens is you get the registration, and then once you start promoting on those IDs which you got or the phone numbers which you got, then you eventually start getting a good traffic out of it. And sometimes people just register for the purpose of registering and then try to get you the site more. I have few recommendations on the site, but since the session is on as a training session, I'll disconnect it and I'll give you suggestions maybe tomorrow or day after tomorrow once I'll check it out. So I have Karthikeyan's duty to do outside this, and Sangeeta here. So I'll give me a day's time. A few things which I kind of want to change on the home site, if I'll be you, I'll share that once. I don't want to share on the record. So it'll be platform. Yes, I got it. Good, good. It's a good initiative which you've taken. I really like it because, I mean, I really love that. Very good business model which I have taken, but on to the cosmetic thing, I have few recommendations. I'll make it off the records, at least to whatever session we're recording. All right, friends, so time to go. Do you want to initiate this thing also? Alright, Sangeeta, why not to do it this way, because it is not doing the DMP duties as such. This I'll be doing just out of the curiosity and, you know, being a marketer. So what we can do is we can just talk, let's say tomorrow, day after tomorrow, you can just give me a call or write me a mail, and then we'll start interacting and I'll give you whatever help I can. And then, yeah. Alright. All right, friends, so time to go. Bye bye. See you next week. Thank you. Thanks. Thanks, Amita. Thanks, KP. Thanks, NK. Bye.